Okay, this video talks a little bit about how to prepare business articles from press releases, particularly earnings. All right, so here's a press release. Community Bank reports 11% increase in 2012. First of all, it's a press release, all right? That means, as a press release, it means we can copy it lock, stock, and barrel. We don't have to change anything. It's fine for us to use as is legally, not a problem. So how do we do these things? First of all, we're going to eliminate, we always eliminate this first bit right here, the Dateline and Business Wire. We don't do that. We take that out. So all we're going to start with is Community Bank. Second of all, what I prefer on these is to make a few changes. Here are the changes. This first paragraph is fine. Community Bank and Independent Business Bank with blah, 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 blah. Today reported an 11% increase. This whole paragraph is fine. We need to say Community Bank, a Pasadena-based independent business bank. So the whole reason we're publishing this is headquartered in Pasadena. So Community Bank, headquartered in Pasadena, an independent business bank with 16 business centers in Los Angeles. Blah, blah, blah. It's fine. The paragraph is fine, but make that change. The next thing is you want to take this quote from this man, and you need to put it up second, in between the first and the second paragraphs. What we don't want is all these numbers, paragraph after paragraph after paragraph of numbers, numbers, numbers. No one's going to read it. So we stick David's name and his comment in up as the second paragraph, right? And his quote is like way too long. You can break this, you can either cut it down or you can break it into two paragraphs. But no one's going to read an entire novel from this guy. Just a quick quote, David. Come on, don't talk so much. So that goes up in after this first paragraph, okay? Because you want to have quotes as your second or third paragraph wherever you can. So here's what I would do. Let me do this here. I'll show you what I would do. Get rid of, what's this on my notepad? Oh, that's an old story. Okay, good. So here's what we're gonna do. This headquarter, this headline is fine, okay? I mean, you can change it if you want, but it's your basic, yeah, that's your basic headline, so that's fine. Then you go here. I'm gonna copy this story. None of this stuff down here is necessary. So here's what we do. I'm gonna go here, copy the story, all right? Now, I'm gonna say Community Bank, an independent business bank, and I don't know why this is capitalized. An independent business bank. Headquartered in Pasadena with 15, 16 business centers, and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so now I'm going to go down here. I'm going to say David Malone. I'm going to take this thing from him. You want quotes in the second paragraph. People are not going to read paragraph after paragraph of numbers. It's too boring. David Malone says a comment to the first quarter. Okay, so I'm going to change this a little bit. I'm going to say, because they want to see the quote. The second, 16. Okay, so we'll do a quote like this. Okay, now we'll go down here. We'll say, of still really long, but this works better. Malone, what's his name? Malone? Malone, yeah, Malone continued. Okay, good. So now, what's the next thing that looks interesting in here? Community Bank. Okay, so let's tell the people who it is. Okay, hang on a second, I did this wrong. Okay, so now we'll tell everybody that this bank has got 2.7 in billion. Okay, so that's we'll tell a little bit about the bank. You hit them with all these numbers, and people are going to run away. It's just that it's too boring. Okay, so I don't want to repeat it. Once is enough. And then we take out all of this stuff. This press release contains, that's all malarkey. Who cares? I don't care what. Okay. So there we go. Now that's the story. We've got a headline that's fine. We've got a first paragraph that points out it's headquartered in Pasadena and gives a synopsis. Then we go right into a quote from David Malone, who probably lives in Pasadena. His friends may read this. So we go into the quote. And he's got a little bit more to say, so we'll give him some more to say. Then we give an overview of who is Community Bank. Then we get back to all the blah, blah, the little crap with the numbers that no one's probably going to read anyway. All they're going to read is that they had an increase in first quarter earnings. That's it. So now this is the final story you should have ended up with, what you see in blue. That's it. That's what we need on these stories. So to summarize, the first paragraph has got to point out that they're based in Pasadena and give everyone a one-sentence summary of what the news is. Okay, they had an 11% increase in their net income to $5.9 million. Yay. Then the second paragraph typically is a quote. Second or third paragraph, whatever you can, as soon as you can get it up there, should be a quotation from a person. What did someone say about the news, this news? That should be in all stories, business stories, news stories, whatever. You got to have a quote as your second or your third paragraph. Then a little bit more background, and then back into the blah, blah. That's the way this should have been done, please. Thank you.